I'm a temporary top dasher, and I've had some good experiences, some bad ones. Today's not gonna be as great as it was last video, where I made like $50 an hour, but the earnings should still be okay. Our first one is $6 for 2.5 miles. It is a part of the Diamond program. I'm not just a top dasher. I'm also keeping my acceptance rate above 70% the entire month so that I can test it out and relay my experiences to you. I may or may not have made a mistake with this next one. It was $6.25 for over 5 miles, and I actually decided to not accept it. I declined it, and it dropped my acceptance rate to a 73% from 74. After declining that one, about like 10 seconds later, I got another for Einstein Bros. This one is $5, like 3.5 miles. It's not a great order. It's not part of the Diamond program, but we are still going to accept it because, of course, we can't afford to just keep dropping our acceptance rate when we're trying to stay above 70% the entire month. And so, yeah, we're gonna take it. I've had problems with Einstein not having orders ready in the past, but I feel like it's gonna be okay. Okay, just a 1 minute wait there in Einstein. I was ready to go. Of course, I understand that a $5 order is not good. It's like at least nothing special, but this one is definitely keeping me like within like 2 miles of my hotspot, and it's keeping me in my zone. If I accepted the last order for $6.25, that would have brought me to a completely different zone. Maybe I would have signed into that one, or maybe I would have driven like the 3 miles back. It just wasn't something I was willing to do, at least for the second order of the day. Whoa, what in the world? What is this order? $14.75 plus, and it's only like 6 miles. This one is so insane. I was not expecting something like this. I was like, okay, let's go drive back to the hotspot 2 miles to go get a $6 order. And this one just out of nowhere. What? All right, well, this is going to more than double the total that we've made so far today. So far we've made $11, and this one's gonna put us around 25, so that's awesome. Well, that was the longest wait I have had in a store so far today. I mean, it's only been 3 orders, but the other two are pretty good. This one was around like a 6-7 minute wait maybe for the items, which I thought was a little bit shocking because it was just like basically one meal and one tiny side. And so I expected it to be like ready before I walked in, but it wasn't. And that's totally fine. I mean, I'm getting paid really nicely for this order. So it is what it is. And then something just even more shocking happened, way more shocking. The customer decided to leave a crazy tip, $20. I made like $22.50 on this order. That's just completely insane. Like, I don't know what made them decide to tip $20. I mean, I'm sure their order total was just like $15, $20, and they left that. Like, that's crazy to me. It was crazy to me when I accepted the order and it was $14.75, and this is nuts. Wow. Okay, so we're moving on to another order. It is Taco Bell. It's not a good one. It's $7 for 6.5 miles, but I do want to say that half of the distance is just getting to Taco Bell. So the customer probably, it's a $7 order, and if I was starting from the restaurant, it would be just like 3-3.5 miles. I really do think there are far worse orders out there than this Taco Bell one. I mean, it was pretty simple, drop me in a good area. And so, although I'm not happy with it, I am definitely, I guess I'm okay with it, but like, of course, whatever. I want it to be higher paying, lower mileage, but I guess I can't really pick them all the time. Next up was Cafe Zupas. This one popped up as soon as I delivered that one for Taco Bell, and it was $7.50 for like 2 miles. Yeah, I'm gonna do it for sure. It is like in a mall area, but luckily it was just on the outside, so I didn't really have to like fight a bunch of traffic or like park my car and walk for like 5 minutes to get to the restaurant. Like, it was relatively easy to do that one. And so, yeah, that was really solid. And the order was ready in the restaurant. And so it was a quick like half mile to the drop off. And it was to an apartment complex, but they met me outside of their building, so it made it a lot easier. And then the sad part came where we got one. It was $4.20 and it was a package. I had to deliver, pick up from somebody's apartment, pick up the package, deliver it to another person's apartment, and then deliver it for $4.20 for like 4 miles. Yeah, I'm not gonna do that. And I did say that I do have to basically accept every single order today after like the first decline, but we can get away with declining this one. I've never done a package delivery on DoorDash. I heard that nobody really likes them, so I'm gonna avoid them if I can. And so I dropped my acceptance rate to 73%. And that's okay because almost instantly we got another one. It was like $13.25 for a stack, 2 restaurants, 1 customer. And the mileage is extremely high, but it's actually bringing me to a better area than the one I'm currently in. So I'm happy about it. So let's go pick this up. Hopefully this one's ready and the second one's ready. And so it can be quick and easy. 5 minute wait in the first restaurant. I guess it's fine. I just went ahead and used their restroom, and so it didn't really feel like I was waiting that long. And then the second one was for Jack in the Box, and the order was ready, but it took like a couple minutes for them to acknowledge me and hand me the food. So after that one, we dropped off at the customer, and I kind of felt like I was on this delivery for a while. Well, that's because I kind of was. It took over 30 minutes to earn those $13, so not great there. Then moved on to a $5 order here. It was like $5.50 actually for 2 miles. This one, I mean, I like it because it's really short, but again, it is just $5.50 there. But the customer met me outside of their place of business, and so that's always nice to see. I mean, it makes it so much quicker than just going like into the building and like try to find them and whatnot. And so, like, I guess that's fine. Now we have a catering order, and this is for $12.50, and it's for 8 miles. So I really don't like this at all. I mean, like, I get payouts like this all the time from non-catering orders for $12 for 8 miles. So not great at all. I'm hoping that I'm waiting at the restaurant long enough to where I can just unassign it penalty free. And then because it is taking me like way outside of my DoorDash zone, I'm gonna have to drive like at least 3-4 miles back in. So that's kind of what I'm hoping for. I guess the second best thing that I hoped to have happen actually occurred. The order was completely prepared before I walked in. And so the person I was talking to just walked over to the bags, checked everything was in there, and then handed it to me, and we were good to go. But the 8 miles, man, I guess there's only like 5 miles left or 6 miles left actually, but it felt like a long way. And I just realized just how far away we are from where we started. And it is not good. We have to drive like 13 miles back just to get to where we were at the beginning of this video, which I intend to do right now so that we can continue to accept more orders over there. That's just what happens when you accept pretty much every order on DoorDash. It can push you all around the map. At least it's nice. It's a little bit better than Uber Eats, because Uber Eats can just send you wherever it wants within your city, I guess. But with DoorDash, you stick to a specific zone. But in this case, I'm outside of the zone now. And yeah, I just have a really far way to go. So I'm going to drive all the way over there. It's going to take like 15 minutes because it's like basically all freeway. That's good. And then we will accept more orders. 20 minute drive complete. And that meant that I had to go to the gas station because I only had like 10 miles left in the tank. So we did that, cost like $55. And if you want to save money on gas like I do, I'd recommend downloading Upside. And if you use my referral link, you can get a bonus 15 cents off per gallon on your first purchase. And it saves me money every time I fill up. So download it. It's the link in my description, be like the first link. Thank you so much. And we'll go to Jersey Mike's because we got one for $8.50 here for like 3 miles or so. I had to reject one. It was for like Chipotle. I just like unpaused myself on DoorDash. First thing that popped up in like a couple seconds was Chipotle for like $5, 7 miles. I was like, what in the world? So I declined it, and my acceptance rate dropped to 74%. So I guess it climbed a few percentage points in the last couple orders. And so now we're here at Jersey Mike's, and it should be a good one. At least I think it will. Hopefully it's ready. With that Jersey Mike's order, it was ready, but they were out of the chips the customer wanted. So I had to contact them. Called them, they answered the first try, which almost never happens, so that is great. And then we got the chip situation sorted out, made our way to the customer, got it dropped off. They left a $6 tip, so that's pretty nice there. And I was put in a really weird spot where there wasn't any restaurants, and I also wasn't getting any orders. And so I just decided to call it a day at around like 3.5 hours, making $88.75 on DoorDash. Definitely not one of my best shifts ever, but absolutely not one of my worst shifts being in the Diamond program and being a top Dasher. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you want to check out any of the other videos, I'll have the playlist right there. And I appreciate you watching. I'll see you next time.